Please rise and call the, August meeting of Police and Fire Board to order. And gentlemen, if you would gather with me and say the Pledge of Allegiance, and then we'll have a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Everybody get a chance to look at the agenda. Is there any changes? If there are none, I'll accept a motion to approve.
Okay, we have another agenda, all right, so we can have time.
Okay. Anything, anybody? Need a motion?
Yes, a motion.
Pledge to approve the approval of the agenda?
Yeah, aye.
Okay.
Aye.
And you're second.
Oh, you made a motion?
I made a motion.
Okay. I can second that.
Not a problem. Okay, we have this public first comment. Obviously, while Gary is wonderful and all, he's not necessarily public. So therefore, we'll pass over that. We have an approval of the previous minutes from April 13th, 2022. Any changes, additions? Anybody have anything? If not, I've got a motion on the floor to approve the minutes.
I'll second.
And I have a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Okay, moving on. Old business. We didn't have anything, I don't believe, back in April with regards to anything that wants to put anything on. The only thing that was on there, as you said, with regards to our
application.
Our application for the board placement. It's just a kind of a reminder. Did you guys fill it out? If you didn't, please take a moment to do that. So we'll please our township. So you have to get it from the zero side of your desk.
No, so it's not a reminder.
I read it 45.
Is it online or?
The form?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Is that much?
I
think you get a fill in which board you're applying for. You know, it just means that there's a blank space for which board. But other than that, board.
I Maria handed out something that has check marks for which committees. But I don't know if you have to do it online and check them out.
Well, it's just a friendly reminder. New business action item. The only thing I had was exactly what Brian had mentioned with regards to the paper from Marie filling it out, and that was the only thing that I was going to mention.
We could mention that the bill did pass.
The bill did pass. Now, I was quite disappointed that I didn't see a sign, not one. And I was disappointed that I didn't get an opportunity to go and throw some signs up and help out.
Who's in charge of that? It used to be my guys.
We're in charge of it?
We can't do it.
Yeah. Oh, no, I know you can't.
Police employer cannot legally do it.
Well, Monty, Dean had a bunch of signs. And I thought when he didn't do it before, he gave them to somebody. And I thought it was you.
Phillips, I think it's Jack Phillips, has them this year. But we were looking at maybe the number of the signs, because we thought we had more somewhere, so maybe he still has them.
I'm thinking there's at least 20 or 30.
I want to say that Jack said that he used the framework
for his signs.
From the religious signs for his
signs, because I think he did end up with them, but that's where they ended up.
Well, I'll make a point to get a hold of him.
And
eight. And at least get them corralled in one spot.
And even I think that's what Jack was trying to do this year, I think.
Yeah.
Because he took the ones from the fire station, and I think he picked up the ones that you guys were kind of storing, or that we're not supposed to, and I think he's got them all.
So you guys can't store them?
No, we can't even technically store them.
Yeah, all right.
So let's hope this isn't being recorded. I don't think it is.
It is. No.
But it is.
No, I know we used to have ours for a long time, so then Jack took it over, so Jack has it all now. So.
Okay. I'll make contact with Jack. Yeah.
But we did think there was more signs than, you know.
I thought there was 100. I don't know.
Well, at one time, there may have been, but.
I thought that. But I remember going out with Art Oxford putting them.
After he was fired.
Yeah.
Well,
but this is a long time.
Good that
At least it passed without.
Right.
About the same hard to do.
Yeah. 79.8 or something like that.
Yeah, usually in the 70s to 80s.
Yeah. Historically. Lyle said that. Lyle told me he said he figured it'd be about 70%.
Yeah, I mean, traditionally it's been at least pushing 70, 75, but this was even a little more than that. Yeah. That's good.
Well, crazy.
It's nice to know the townships, of course.
Okay, we don't have any items for introduction. To my knowledge, unless someone here does. Now, tonight. So, we go on to the police department agency updates and discussion.
For the police department. We have one of the two new officers that were hired the first of the year. Went back to the Clinton County Sheriff's Department where he had worked years before, so we stated he didn't have to go back to. He ended up with a new sheriff. He ended up going back to them. We advertised this opening and no hires were made, so we extended it twice now after the deadline. And now we have basically an application that's ongoing until it's filled. And in this last extension, we got no applicants at all. If you look at the police academy, generally it used to be like you had a handful of sponsorships from agencies, and the majority of them were self-sponsored. Well, now it's everyone in there now is, I think, just about 100% agency-sponsored. So,
is Matt willing to do that?
There's talks of it. I mean, you know, with the Trustee Elmer agency, there were some talks going on, and at some point, I think we got to get creative. We've tried to do bumping up to the first or second year step, because I think in our contract that you've got, you can bump it up one step. And I think the board has been open to discussion of bumping up more. But even then, I truly believe now that people that are at agencies that they wanted to leave have already done so. And so now it's kind of everybody's where they want to be in police work, and there just isn't the people going into this job. For obvious reasons. So I think we got to get creative in the coming year, and you know, there's a lot of things that we can do, but obviously if the need isn't there, the want, rather, for people to go into police work. I mean, we started off years ago, I was a cadet, I think Lyle was a police cadet, but all that started in like the high school and kind of mentored people, maybe we get back to that. Exactly, you know, and get people exposed to it and see what it's about versus what they see on the media. But I think we're probably going to have to look, you know, go to the board and look at, you know, potentially sponsoring one or two people, because I've never seen it where you open it up and you didn't get an applicant.
Well, yeah. You guys talked about getting more reserves.
We haven't, because the reserve can't work on a loan, you know.
Right.
We're working with an officer, so, you know.
But at least you have to do it.
Have you advertised outside of?
Yeah, we advertised on Al Cole's website, which is the certifying agency for police, which I mean, honestly, with last time I went on there, I think there's probably 400 or 500 agencies hiring right now. Everybody's in the same boat.
Everybody's looking.
You know, and you got, you know, like we just read Eaton County's, some of their ARPA money, they're talking about giving the officers $10,000 and certain sign-up bonuses, and Dinan County's got, I don't know, last year, like $6,000 sign-up bonus, and I firmly believe some of that may help, but it's not about the money. It's
not supposed to be, but
no, it's not. And it's a, you think you, to move people around might be about the money, but to get them into this job, I don't think it's about just about the money.
My understanding is Bath Police Department pays pretty well and retains officers for a long time.
Tell you what, yeah, it's a, you know, when I started here back in 92, I think, for the first time, nobody ever left here. Yeah. So I ended up, because that's part that I had to go to the west side and wait for an opening, and I came back in 96. But, you know, this is unprecedented times right now. I don't know. It's,
I don't think COVID helped.
No.
People not want to work in general.
In general, yeah. And, you know, the media's not helping our cause.
Yeah.
And I think people are seeing the backlash of that now, where, I mean, LPD, everybody's got shortages right now. We do have, this coming Monday, we're doing two interviews. One was from a police candidate, the original, back in January or December of last year. He backed out at the last minute because his family didn't want to move. And then later contacted us and said, you know what, I made a mistake. We're up to moving. And he'd like to get back in it. And then another one was from this first round of this latest three rounds. But he wasn't certified because he'd been on police work for a couple of years. And he since went through MCOLs and was able to get his certification back. And I think he's waiting for a waiver school to get in right now, this month or next month. So.
Well, I think you're really good one. And Gary probably already knows this, but Hobart Police Department.
Hobart?
Yeah. They lost their chief, who retired. They hired a new chief. Chief came in and started making all kinds of changes. Then he found out that the, believe it or not, that the town actually had something to say about how we spent money.
Yeah.
Oh. Isn't that neat?
Yeah.
But anyway, so he decided he was going to leave. So he left. The last I knew, well, they hired one now, a police officer. But prior to that, the only person they had was a part-time officer, and I can't remember when it was, like, maybe MSU police. Somebody like that, that was it, who happened to be there.
Yeah.
And it just blew my mind. I said, and he said, we put out flyers and stuff, and we ended up getting back four candidates. And they had to interview four candidates. Now, apparently, out of the four, they only got one that was suitable or agreeable to come to work. So, it's horrible. It's absolutely horrible. So, go ahead, Gary.
Officer Greg Welch retired, I think officially on May 1st of 2020 of this year. I'm sure you've heard Chief Violent Lynn Mulder expected to retire at the end of this year. The new, we got a new canine Tahoe was in.
I'm sorry, a new what?
New Tahoe
patrol
vehicle is in the 2022. We're waiting for some of the canine stuff to be put in it, but it's orders, but it's still not in yet. And it's obviously, with the COVID, everything's higher, and everything's taking longer to get it. And even if we can get it.
And those have like a ramped up air conditioning stuff.
There's a lot of stuff, yeah, separate air conditioner, alarm, door pop, all that stuff. And some of the stuff we're reusing, but unfortunately with the new Tahoe, it's a new model year, so a lot of stuff doesn't change over, so. Cage, the screen, the seat, etc., etc.
The camp Lincoln on General Motors does a full through throughout everything. Guides, boards, everything. You make yourself sick going crazy, sheet and you start looking at stuff and you see yourself. This guy just bought this cage last year. That's what else.
Sure, yes. I mean, even like I called the graphics place out of St. John's to get the new patrol car wrapped in the graphics. And he said, well, let me call you back. I knew something was up. I go, I called him back because he never called me back. He said, I can't get the colors you need. I said, when are you going to get them? He said, I have no idea if I'm ever going to be able to get them. So I don't know. We're going to have to get something close or change graphics.
I got one of your old door shields.
Yeah, we got some old shields. Just the rest of the set. He said, I really thought they were kind of just holding back. I mean, because I called manufacturers. He said, they have no idea when and if they're ever going to build.
They got a set of the blue stripes, too.
Half car.
I mean, I do a midnight recon and take some blue stripes off the East Lansing cars.
There you go. And then you got them
done? Oh, those East Lansing guys who want to get a bunch of cars.
We picked up one last year. As far as call volume, this year, from January through July, we're down about 1,500 calls. Almost all of them can be attributed to business checks and property checks. We attribute to that. We were training two new guys for months on end. And when you're training, you're actually going through training the whole time. So some of that is because of that. As far as next year's budget, which is not, we're waiting for Karen to get the spreadsheet to us, but the only thing we're asking for is another patrol car to replace one of the highest mileage patrol cars. And along with that comes also because it is a new model year, or it's a second model year, it's a new model year that we got now, is the cage, the seat, the screen is going to have to be replaced along with some other things. And as you know, the price on everything is astronomically going up, and it's hard to budget for, if you can get it, what the cost is going to be to get it, and when you'll actually get it. So, other budgetary items, other than the Tahoe outfitting is just the things for inflation and the collective bargaining agreement with the police and sergeants. So, that's all I have.
Any questions of Gary? Do I can answer? You're 100% right, and I believe I told you that I've had one cage manufacturer that builds cages for patrol cars. They went up 40% from January 1st to last year. And they had another light manufacturer that had three raises from January to now. And they must have about almost 30%.
That's almost as much as hamburgers have gone up.
Yeah.
Go to a restaurant, you pay $15 for a $5 hamburger now.
I went to McDonald's, my brother and I, the other day, had just a cheap breakfast, $17.89. I thought, did you ever think you'd pay $17.89 for just a
crappy breakfast?
For a I went to go to Meijer for lunch today to get chicken and mashed potatoes. They said, we don't have mashed potatoes. I said, you don't have them today, or are you out? Or they said, we can't get them. I mean, they're potatoes.
Yeah, it's horrible. It's absolutely horrible. Well, I don't know where Dave went.
So they can call for him.
Oh,
we can come back to them.
Yeah, we can come back to them. Well, we're public comments and there's no public. The township board reporter is not here.
So we don't know who's replacing
them? We don't know. There's an election in November between a Democrat and a Republican. And one of them will.
But he still serves until
he serves until he has to turn down his sentence. He's a responsibility.
He might have forgotten. Have you got any member comments? There's a lot of little member comments if you'd like.
Does it have to pertain to the police and fire force? Because I have lots of comments.
If that's the case, yes.
Okay. No comment.
While you're waiting, I'm going to run up the stats so we can get them in the minutes.
I'll be right back. If you want, you can just write them out and give me a copy.
Okay.
And I'll just have them in a minute.
All right. Yeah, I got them on my desk, and I thought I grabbed all the paperwork, but apparently I didn't, so.
Or make a copy or whatever.
You can do it now. Whatever you want.
I can put up any house right away.
All right. I just give you any more than we're all done.
Except for you.
Okay. I'm done. Run numbers for as of July 22, we were at 7. of 727. This year that included 17 runs on the 4th of July weekend, which I'm not sure I'll have. My anniversary is 4th of July. I'm not sure I'll have another one because I wasn't home much. But anyway, it is what it is. It just happens.
Was most of that stupidity?
Yeah, just medicals and, yeah, exactly, stupidity. I mean, there didn't seem like there were that many people in town. I know there weren't that many of our guys around. So.
Were they fireworks related?
No, no, not really. It was all just medical. We didn't have all
stress.
Goofy fireworks. Yeah, heat, stress. And like you said, got that alcohol in there too. But, we do have, and we basically, the last time I talked, I read the minutes here that I told you we had two new hires. We are now, with those two, we're at a total of five.
Five new hires?
Yes. One of them came from St. John's. He relocated. He's fire trained. Not medical yet. And another guy of those five works for Lincoln Mercy. He actually went to the fire academy and the EMS academy at Lander at Lincoln Community College. So he's fully trained. The other three, just good all-around people that we'll put through the training as we need to, as it becomes available. We had two in choir school that started in January at our station. We had multiple people from multiple agencies, but the choir school ended, and our two guys that we had in the class have passed the test, and everybody's cool there. We also had a two-weekend officer class for what they call Instructor 1 now. That was hosted at our department. That all went well. And we're going to start an MFR, our medical first responder class, in September at our station. And that's almost full of the maximum 20 that Kevin's going to teach there. So that's looking good. So we're becoming a lot of area training in our department. I think that's a good thing. Just keep us out there and keep us moving. Our two full-time guys' positions are just about set to go here with the township. We're finally getting real close to getting those done. I know we want to talk about budget. We don't really have any major changes, little tweaks here and there. I would assume basically just because of COVID and prices up and down is what we're not planning on adding any major to the budget this year as far as the fire department goes. Other than, and there is a truck fund. We've discussed the air truck and the compressor on the air truck. It's functional, but you have to shut it off, and that's probably not good when you're talking 5,000 PSI. So it's functional, but it needs to be replaced. There's been discussion. I've been in discussions with the chief from Meridian. He's willing to go in on us with a grant. If we just have two departments, he says it's a lot easier. Meridian's done a lot of grants successfully, so that may be a possibility to get the compressor changed on the current truck. I've also been kind of looking at replacing the whole truck with a truck that has a compressor on it, newer, yeah, yeah. So we're kind of, I'm still going round and round with that, so to speak. The other big thing that I think we need to do is to start working on our replacement fire truck is scheduled for 2025. Sounds like a long ways away, but it takes a while to get a truck spec'd and, you know, just giving something. I know that people are a year and a half out to order a fire truck now. So
is this like the big fire truck?
Big full size, right. Class A pumper, yeah.
The multi $100,000 vehicle.
And nowadays you're probably talking, yeah.
40%.
Pushing a million probably, between $800,000 and a million nowadays, I would imagine. But we did a lot of quality looking at FDIC when we were down there in April. I mean, there's a legitimate companies out there that do it. You know, we've been traditionally stuck with Pierce and done a good trucking, but that doesn't mean we can't look to more of a conventional chassis, which would be considerably cheaper. And we'll probably look at it for sure and see where it goes from there. But I think we need to start working on it. Like I said, I know 3 years sounds like a long time, but if we wait till 2024, it isn't going to happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just the availability of stuff, the materials, and you
know, running it out.
Get out ahead of it. Yeah.
Yep.
Well, question on Monday, but half of
that in or sell.
Sure. Or you can definitely sell what, yeah, have that money back out of that debt line. Yeah. They're in decent shape, but as you get, our oldest one is about 2. Obviously, we don't run every day like a Vinnie Sock Fire and things like that. But then it starts to be getting, you know, the technology of 20 or 2002.
Right.
It's hard to replace when it gets to be that far out of whack, too. Yeah. So there's things that it's like, we're going to blow it out until we get a new truck, so to speak. So nothing major, nothing mechanical, nothing major. You know, I'm just saying, the little fiddly things of the air conditioner pump that pumps the water from up here to the top of the dam down the side, and things like that that are becoming more difficult to find on some things. But other than that, I don't have anything. I do have, so to speak, broken down by incident here. If anybody wants to look it over for on through the end of July, just kind of interesting if anybody wants to look at it real quick for numbers of this, that, and that thing by the category. That I ran off of what we use now for documenting our fire and EMS calls on the same thing, so I can easily pull that up as far as breaking it down for categories. So that's kind of cool. And I'll continue to do that. I think it's interesting, like you say, there's 580 medicals on there, and the rest of them are separated out into other things. But
do you have overdoses on there?
Yeah, there should be listed on there separately, yes.
Is that gone up or down, or staying the same?
We haven't seen a major increase.
It was really increasing.
Yeah. I think, and I'm sure Gary will agree, it depends on all of a sudden you get a bad batch that comes off somewhere, and you hear it. You know, St. John's has it, and then all of a sudden the back has it, and it spreads. But I think it's more of that nowadays. You get them, yeah.
Okay.
And some of them may not be listed on that as. I know we had one the other day that was quite possibly an overdose, but he was dead on arrival when we got there and went down for long enough that there wasn't any working.
Yeah.
I don't know how that reflects on that report, so to speak, whether that would be dead on arrival or whether it would be an overdose cause of.
Was that one just a couple days ago?
Yeah.
A friend's daughter that's trained to be EMT, she was on arrival after that.
Ah, okay.
It opened your eyes.
Oh, that. It can do that. So I here again, like Gary, we're having a hard time getting quality people, and not that they're not quality people, but I agree with previous Chief Danover's theory of, you know, quality over quantity. You know, if you have 30 rundowns, then you can't really, you know, yeah. So I think we're doing fair, and like, especially, you know, you talk to Gary, comparatively, it's hard to get paid on call department as opposed to even, you know, a full-time officer, but there's a lot more training that goes into that before they hire them. We wind up training them after we hire them, some of them. So it is what it is, but I think we're doing okay. I'm feeling a little better. You know, yeah, we've been doing some advertising on the sign, things like that, Facebook, but I don't know how else to do it. Kicked around the school idea. We've got one young man that has been coming to trainings and things like that. He's shown some interest, but for us, I feel we got to be out of high school. You can't be doing this all night and then get up and go to school in the morning. So I pretty well stick with the fact you've got to be a graduate of high school. Not just 18, but 18 and high school grade.
Or, yeah.
Because he's 18 now, and it's like, but still got his senior year. That can happen very easily nowadays. So I was like, you can keep going to training, so we'll keep your interest as much as we can here, but just can't do it.
Can you get certified?
Good possibility you could.
Under your training stuff?
Oh, yeah, under our training. I don't know.
And then once he graduates?
Yeah, I don't think he would have time for that, because that's like two nights a week.
Okay.
When we do the fire school, that's starting again in January, two nights a week, and about every other weekend for 6 months. And so it's kind of a load that I need to put that on a kid that's trying to create a better one.
Sure.
I believe that's all that I
thanks, Dave.
Sure.
Is anyone or everyone aware that that township has a neighborhood watch? And you are able to get the downloads of this from the internet?
Yes.
Well, this is made, but...
Right, I get an update, a weekly update from Chris Cole, every Friday.
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, this is available if you want to keep track on hotspots area. If you happen to be driving around the area and you see some little Dickens is doing something wrong, you could possibly make, contact with Lyle Gary and we do a special attention for the area, which I'm sure they're doing now. But it's pretty interesting. I went through that. Well, I'll be honest with you. I think it was last Friday I went through that one. And I was amazed at how much activity there is on that sheet. Oh my gosh. Amazing.
You get more vehicle players than I thought.
Yeah.
Jeez.
All the electric ones are starting to pile
up. Yeah.
You haven't got enough water. There's just no way.
I'm surprised at the low number of wildlands on this.
Yeah, that's been pretty good, and even when it was dry, these last few weeks, beginning of July, it's stayed pretty mild. We had one the other day after all the rain, there was a little grass fire going out here in the median of 69, so I thought it would have happened out there, but...
You talk about things happening, and leave the subject here for a minute. So my partner was going to lunch. Let's see, it was Thursday. Going to lunch, and he was right there on South Cedar Street where Meyer did. And there were two people sitting on that side, one on each side, one in the middle, and one on the one lane and one in the other lane. We all know how much traffic goes through there. Well, one of them decided that they're going to run across the street. And I would put it to you this way. We assume by their headdress and their garb that they were not Anglo-Saxon or American. However, this woman got hit by this car. And the driver of the car never saw her. And she went about 20 feet in and went about, God knows how far, into the other side of the road. And I have not seen nothing on Stadium or on the news about that lady. I've been really concerned about her that she may have died. Because they had a child involved, and I'm assuming a male there as well. I'm thinking it was a family. And it just would be horrible if mom died. Anyway. All right. Anything else? Murray, we can back up a little if you have something.
I'm sorry, I forgot.
Okay.
Me and my big mouth in there, so okay. You've heard enough.
Okay. Well, I guess that's it. Member comments?
Ben?
Mr. Jenkins?
Yes.
Yes, sir? I have none other than I understand what a difficult time everyone is having trying to find out. So I do not have an answer. The sad part about it is it's not just police department. It's trying to find quality people who really, honest to God, want to work. And I believe that come down the road a little ways, we're all going to be in trouble, personally. And with that, I'll ask for a movement to adjourn.
Okay, small.
Yeah, one, yeah.
Yep. 90 seconds.
Second.
You want a second?
Sure. Sorry.